Hello everyone and welcome back to another Star Wars action figure review. Today I got for you is the Black Series 6-inch Guardians of Evil Elite Praetorian Guard. Now this is a close, oh not even close, this is almost becoming my first favorite besides the Shadow Guard. I mean, it's so close to tell, with me anyways, it's just I love them both. Now there are, in The Last Jedi, because this is where he's going to be from, at least one other variation, which the Amazon exclusive I have on pre-order, and I hope to get him soon and give you guys a look at him as well. For now, let's go ahead and take a look at this guy. I just love the way these guys look. I love the armor, and of course also love the coloring as well, though it's all red, but still. Just overall, really, really nice. And his kama is made of the same material as the Imperial Royal Guard, Senate Guard, and the Shadow Guard. It's really soft and it flows very nice. And the only accessories he came with were these blades. And they both look the same, except what you do is you take them both and you combine them to do so, like this. I mean, you probably could do this as well, though it doesn't seem like it fits too well. And but mostly, it's supposed to be like this. And let me see if I can get into one of his hands to show you guys. Though I will admit this hand in particular is a little sketchy at times. There we go. Very cool. The other thing I wanted to point out is both these shoulder pieces, you can actually pop them out like so. I think that's just so they can move around and not get in the way of the actual joint in there. And, believe it or not, this is where my complaint is about to come in. So, let's get started. Articulation? Okay. He has a ball-hinged head. Ball-hinged shoulders. And this is where the figure, for me, suffers the most, and if it wasn't like this, I'd give him a 10 out of 10, but as it is, I'll give him a 9, or 9.5 out of 10. They have two ball-jointed points in his arm, so it's like one about right here and one right above it, so it's two ball joints. Except because of the way they did it, or because of the armor, they don't even move hardly. I mean, they'll swivel and stuff like that, but if you want to move them up or down, that's it. That is all you get. That's just really sad. And he has like ball hinged elbows, though those are also restricted due to that armor as well. A ball jointed or ball hinged upper torso. Ball jointed hips. Swivel thighs. Double hinged knees. And ball-hinged swivel ankles. Again, if it wasn't for that, it would be perfect. Now, one thing I do want to touch on is these knee joints. They're good. I mean, I like how they did this in particular. You would think this armor plate would, like, restrict it or something, but no, it seems like they molded it in between the joint so it doesn't interfere with anything. And here is the packaging, again. And here is the bio if you wish to pause the video and read. And that's all the time I have for this action figure review, guys. Until next time, Admiral, alert my Star Destroyer to prepare for my arrival.